Hello everyone. So this time I will make the electrical system for my tractor, and all the 3D parts that I will be using will be available on Thingiverse. I hope so. I will improve them so that everything fits better than in this video, and so that you can use it for you. At the end of this video I will explain how it works and I will test it. So like I've already said, I've 3D printed this part that will support the electrical system for my tractor, and it will support the relays like this and the fuses that will fit into these holes. So to do this I will have to put blade connectors into the holes. But there is a problem. The round holes that you can see aren't wide enough for the tail of these connectors. So I will have to make them bigger by hand with a hand drill. I've printed thick walls so that I can modify this part. Then I will have to solder these wires at the back in the right way. The idea here is that the plus that comes from an imant goes in there, and this will turn on two relays. Here comes in the permanent plus, and the main relay will connect that to everywhere here at the bottom. This second relay will turn off the engine by connecting this wire here to the negative terminal.
Ce fil-là sera relié au moins quand on éteindra le contact.
And at the bottom we have four relays that will serve to turn on whatever we want. So the headlights, the fans to cool down the engine and so on.
C'est-à-dire les phares, les ventilateurs pour refroidir, etc., etc.
For every one of them we got a fuse. And we'll put a button between these two wires to turn the corresponding relay on. So I've managed to put a connector in there. It doesn't go into it as deep as I thought. And at the back it comes out in order to solder a wire on it. Now I've inserted all connectors. It forces a little bit when I try to insert a relay, but it works. So now I'll have to make the connections between the connectors with wires. I've got wire of different colors that I found in my scrap.
I've been carrying my trouble and this pack strapped to my shoulder ever since I was a baby. I've been running from everything I know. Don't you tell me about my trouble, 'cause you know nothing about my trouble. Nobody knows about my trouble except for my baby and me. Well, I was born a cowboy way out west in New Mexico. But times are tough, we had to let it go. We moved to town, but they couldn't move it out of me. It's way down in my blood, thicker than anyone understood. Nobody thought that I ever would get away with the trouble in me. And I've been carrying my trouble in this pack strapped to my shoulder. Ever since I was a baby, I've been running from everything I know. Don't you tell me about my trouble. Nobody knows about my trouble. Nobody knows about my trouble. Except for my baby and me. Well, it didn't take too long for the pills in the bottom of a bottle to dig a deep grave with a shovel and bury it.
Maintenant, j'ai fini ce circuit.
Now I've finished this circuit. I hope everything is connected in the right way. Now I'll have to connect these wires with the outside.
Et ça, c'est une sortie de plus après le contact. Donc il va falloir brancher maintenant tout ça à l'extérieur, mais avec le biais de cosses plates.
This time I'll use the other flat connectors,
des petites barrettes comme ça.
Blade connectors, I mean. And for that I've printed these pieces, two of them, symmetrical.
Elles viennent comme ça. Et donc là, j'en ai fait de tout format. Donc celle-ci, elle
these will go here, this will go on the side, these on the top, and here we will have to print one more for this side.
Donc cette fois, c'est des cosses, c'est les cosses.
These are the connectors that I'll be using. They are meant to go in there like this.
Rentrer ici, comme ça.
And the symmetrical one goes above it, like that.
Donc, faut bien le mettre. Voilà. Et donc là, on peut brancher.
Here you can connect the wire that you want.
Qu'on veut. Donc le fil qu'on veut. Et voilà le travail.
Here it is. You see, there is a gap. But it will close when I'll screw it on a wooden plank.
Ça sera vissé sur du bois, de toute façon. Donc l'idée, c'est que tous les câbles ici.
The idea is that every wire will be connected to a connector. So now I've printed this board that will go under the circuit, and that's to isolate the circuit from the wood. The goal is to make holes in this plastic board so I can put the screws through it.
Donc la plaque, c'est pour isoler les circuits électriques du bois qui sera dessous.
Now we will wire this up with the exterior. Like I said before, these are the main power supply commands. We've got the Niemann with two wires, one yellow and one white. And the yellow one will be connected to the plus 12 volt. And this white one will come right here. This will turn on both relays when you turn on the contact. The first relay will turn on everything below here. And it will be connected to the permanent plus that goes in there. And the second relay will just turn off the ignition by connecting the CDI wire to the negative when the contact is off. So it disconnects it when you turn the contact on.
Et ça, ça va être pour éteindre l'allumage de ce bloc CDI. Donc en fait, il faudra relier ce fil-là, ici, pour que dès qu'on éteigne le contact, ça mette ce fil sur la masse, et donc ça éteindra l'allumage. Ensuite, on a
this
un fil de masse qui doit venir ici.
The negative wire. And the last connector is just a plus that goes
et
on when the contact key is turned on, but I've got much more on the other side. So the first two are connected with this fuse.
Et on a ici un fusible qu'on pourra brancher qui servira pour ces.
And these three here are connected with this fuse, and the last two are connected with the last fuse.
On est bon. Maintenant, ici on a à chaque fois.
Here we got four relays.
Un relais
and so this relay is connected via a fuse.
À côté, on a
and beneath it, we've got one wire ici with a fuse.
Et donc,
and we want to power, for example, the headlights with this relay. So we'll have one button that will be connected to the plus via this fuse, and from the button we go back to the relay to turn it on and off, and this last will turn the lights on, and it will be the same principle for all four relays at the bottom.
Voilà, donc ça c'est le principe pour tous ces quatre relais qui sont en bas ici. Donc il y en aura au moins un donc pour
so,
la lumière.
I'll need one for the lights, one for the cooling fan.
Donc les ventilateurs là. Donc là au lieu du bouton, on aura
instead of the button we'll have this thermostat to turn the fans on. And these connectors at the side can be used for small things like indicator lights and especially the petrol gauge, because I've got this fuel tank from a scooter with an incorporated floater, and I could find the plug that fits in there. So now I'll just have to find the gauge itself. When I've unmounted everything to make the connections, I've seen this charging device, and it has a wire that has to be connected to the plus. And before it was just on the battery, but now I'll connect it here via this fuse. So now that the most important is installed, the main relays and the fuse for charging the battery, let's see if the relays click if you turn it on. Yes, they do. At least one of them. I don't know if you can hear it. So let's see if the engine starts. The engine stops with the contact key. Perfect. Now we'll see with the multimeter if the battery is charging. It seems to be charging. Now, temporarily, I have connected the permanent plus here to that thermostat so that the engine can cool down. Finally, I've chosen a 60 degrees Celsius thermostat, but the problem is that it cools down faster than the engine because it's in front of the fan. Maybe I will place it behind the engine.
Cette partie-là que le bloc moteur entier. Donc je sais pas, je vais peut-être modifier ça, je vais peut-être le placer à un endroit.
Now the fan's turned off, but it's only the thermostat that is cool and the engine is still hot.
Donc là ça va durer un moment.
So I don't really know how to place it and which temperature to choose.
Thermostat et quelle température prendre. Thank you.